So this is one of our autonomous driving vehicles. The technology that we are using is radar and vision. We don't have LiDAR right now, even if, of course, our system can handle also LiDAR. The vision system is divided in two parts, the long range and the short range, and we will see that in a minute. And then we have radars, one radar in each corner of the car, plus one in the front.
So we have cameras and radar. The vision system is based on 18 cameras. The radar system is based on 5 radars. So we have 18 cameras, 5 radars. The information coming from the road, from the car, that means GPS and IMU and all the other information coming from the car. Everything goes to the board with CV3 inside. So all the sensors are delivering raw information to the board with CV3. And there's where all the processing happens, into CV3. And the result of that is sent to the actuators on the car through a CAN interface. So that's the autonomous driving system. It's very simple. So just sensors, the board for processing, and the car. That's it. Then on this car, we also have a PC for this visualization and for data acquisition. But the autonomous driving part is the green part. So it's very simple.
Okay.
There are two important things to notice about this car. First one is that the autonomous driving stack is based on neural networks. So all the little pieces that you see here, so the perception, the creation of the map, the planning, everything is running with neural networks. That's important to note because it's very different from what we had 2 years ago, and we have to change that to actually to fit very well on CV3. Second thing is that we don't have this kind of maps, so that we don't have HD maps. So the HD maps, what's in the picture here is what we were using 2 years ago. These were very, very detailed descriptions of the world. So you had very nice and dense lane markings, curbs, traffic lights. Everything was very, very detailed and very precise. But of course, it cannot scale because it can scale for one little city, but not for the whole world. So what we're doing today is that we are using this kind of maps. So this is the SD map, so the standard definition map. And as you can see, they are formed by just segments. So one segment is one road. And we have connection between segments, so connection between roads. And these are the junctions. And there's also the information about the presence of a traffic light. But that's it. So there are no more information about road width or where the position, the correct position of the traffic light is. So there's nothing like that. So this is all perceived in real time while we drive. So I think we can now start. I will switch to the visualization of the real-time visualization. Okay, so actually Chiara is driving right now, is manually driving. You will see, everything you see here on the monitor is perceived in real time. It's a result of the processing of the radar and vision. So now, actually, we are in autonomous mode. You can see Chiara just switched on the system. It's red here. That means that we are driving autonomously. And again, you will see here the results of the perception. For example, we have a car in front of us, and you can see it here. We have cars on the other side of the road moving in the opposite direction. And we also can see the traffic light. It's red here, and we have a red traffic light in front of us. So now I will show you the different perceptions. So in this case is the classification of the image, which is coming from the frontal camera. You can see blue is the car, red is the curb, white is the lane markings. And for example, you can also see the curb on the other side of the road down there, quite far away. And again, we also have traffic lights, which are yellow. Pedestrians are red, so we have different colors for different objects. And we do the classification from the frontal cameras, as you can see now, and all the other cameras around. So the lateral cameras, the back cameras, and whatever. So this is running at the same time on all the cameras. And again, this is the monocular processing, just one camera. But we also have stereo in this car. So we have two cameras pointing in the front. And this is the result coming from the stereo system. And I can change the point of view so you can actually see it's a real point cloud, 3D point cloud. So in this case, red means close and green means far away. And then we have all the shades in between. So for example, on the right-hand side, you can see, I can zoom in a little bit. You can see the curb on the right-hand side. You can see the vehicle in front of us. You can see the vehicle behind us, and in the on the left-hand side. So this is done all by stereo vision. I can also change the point of view now. Okay, and I will change also the visualization, because I would like to show you the traffic light. Actually, it became green now, so we have a green light in front of us. So we can go. We can also see all the other vehicles here, all the other cars.
Sorry.
Okay. So look at that. Now we are facing a junction with another traffic light. Maybe okay, it's engaged. Another junction with a traffic light. The traffic light is not seen because it's behind. Okay, now it's seen, because it was behind the tree, so it's usually seen at the very last moment. So we usually get there and we slow down until we see the traffic light. Now I will show you how we create the map. So in this case, yellow is the map. So for this big road here, we have just one line. So there are also roads on the right-hand side. You can see them here. These are these yellow lines on the right-hand side. And this is the starting point, so that's the map. Then on top of that, we create the real-time view, which is the light blue part. And we do that by adding information like curbs, lane markings, number of lanes, and so on. So everything we see. So for example, there's a road coming up here on the right-hand side. We don't see it, but we start painting something. And when we are close, we create the exact shape of that one. Now we're let me change the point of view now, because we're facing an intersection, which is again green, so that's easy. Okay, so it's staying on the right lane now. Again, here there is written driving. That means this is the behavior that the system selected for this situation. So driving means just go. If we had for example, a traffic light, a red traffic light, that would become regulation, because we need to adhere and follow the regulation. Okay, what's going to happen now is that we're going to turn right at the traffic light. So anytime now, the system will be doing a lane change. Anytime. Okay, slowing down now. So, okay. Turning the indicator is on, and then it's changing lane. And then we will have a red light in front of us. And this is interesting. You can see the red light here. We have a red light, but this car can also do a turn on red. So we will come to a complete stop now. We will stop, and then we'll try to move forward to check if we can do a turn on red. So that's... That's very busy. That's very interesting. Oh, ouch. Oh, okay. Sorry.
We are already here.
Yeah, but I think you disengaged. Okay, anyway, we're moving now. So everything was cleared out. So unfortunately, she touched the steering wheel, because whenever you touch the steering wheel, it disengages.
I immediately engage it again, so all the maneuver were performed.
The correct way. Okay, so let me summarize that with In this view, you see all the low-level information coming from all the sensors. So yellow is the radar, and red is coming from the stereo, green as well. And you can see, for example, the cars on the other side. We put bounding boxes around them. So this is what we do with the low-level information. And then we'll switch to the clean view. So this is the clean view where you have vehicles and drawings. And you can also see the map is being created as we go. Now we'll go back and Chiara will take back to manual driving. Okay, so the last thing that I would like to show you is the following. So I just mentioned we have been running on CV3. So the full self-driving is using CV3. And this chart shows the... Okay. So this chart shows the percentage of usage of CV3. So with the in the test drive that we just did today, we have been using only half of the two GVPs that we have. The GVP is the generic vector processor. We have been using less than two MVPs. So the MVP is the neural vector processor. So only two of the six that we have. Mm-hmm. And we have been using just one arm out of the 16 that we have. So it, the processor, so this SoC is pretty empty. There's plenty of room to add more processing on top of that. What we will be doing next is that we will, of course, we will also add processing, but we will move the whole thing to the smaller version of CV3. So CV3 685, which has only three MVPs and three ARM clusters. This will happen in the next few months. So again, it's all the driving today has been done thanks to CV3, which is connected to all the sensors and doing the processing and the fusion at low level.